This evening, we have a very rare privilege indeed, as this program will be dedicated to Richard Pryor, native son that we're welcoming home this evening. We're going to have an opportunity to see the many faces of Richard Pryor, what the impact of his return home has been, the outpouring of love and affection from his many friends, admirers, and certainly those well-wishers who wish him the best with his production, JoJo Dancer. Get our show started this evening. We have a good friend of mine who we are always glad to have in the studio, Director of our Public Housing Authority, Herman Jurel, a lifetime Peorian. Jurel, what has been your reaction to Richard's return home?
Well, I think that it's a beautiful thing on Richard's part in terms of coming back to the community. A role model for some of the youngsters in terms of all of the types of activities and various movies that Richard has been involved with. And the man's a comic genius and an actor extraordinaire.
Well, one of the things that I've been certainly impressed about, and we're going to be talking to some of the people later in the program, are friends who he's reached out to who are going to have, for their very first time, an opportunity to be part of a movie experience from the other side of the camera, and that's the other side of the TV set as well. How do you feel? What does that do for Peoria?
Well, certainly in the eye of the economic storm that Peoria is involved with at this particular time, and we need as many pluses that we can multiply in terms of trying to garner any kind of revenue into our city. And some of the young folk and some of the folk who are going to be involved in terms of JoJo Dancer, it's just a small tip of the iceberg in terms of the talent that is already here in our city.
I notice even in your work environment, some of the employees who are involved with you are going to have an opportunity to participate. I had the occasion to even talk with a resident of Warner who's going to be participating with the movie. The electricity that seems to be circulating in the community about Richard's return home, I think is breathtaking. I'm even excited about having an opportunity to share in an experience where, as we were talking earlier, before the show started, and one of the ministers was saying he traveled to Texas, a guy said, where you from, and kind of, he said he felt kind of funny when he said Peoria, and everybody began to snicker. But I think this movie will certainly begin to, as the brother says, stop people from laughing at Peoria and start them laughing with Richard.
Right. Richard, again, has exemplified that benevolence that he has so often done in reference to organizations and individuals here in the city. There are many faces and many folds of Richard Pryor that many folk probably do not know. And he is a benevolent individual and has displayed that over the years in terms of Peoria. And the fact that he's come here to do one of his productions is simply marvelous.
Joe, appreciate you stopping by.
Thanks for the invite.
Mm-hmm. Okay, have a good day.
Thank you.
Hello, Richard. I'm Mary Grabs, president of the United Usher Board of Peoria. We wish to congratulate you and thank you for coming back home to film your movie. May God bless and keep you forever. Love always, the United Usher Board.
You know, as we promised you tonight, as we welcome home Richard Pryor, that we were going to bring some friends in who were just going to kind of chat and share some old memories, and also some of the individuals who have had an opportunity to meet with Richard since he's been back to Peoria and who are going to be participating in his movie, JoJo Dancer. Right now in the studio, I have with me Bobby Cagle and Johnny Dismuke. Glad you gentlemen could stop in this evening.
Pleasure, man.
Bobby, maybe just kind of get us started. Tell us a little bit about your reaction to Richard coming home.
Well, my reaction, I've always knew that Richard hadn't changed, you know, by listening to a lot of his, watching his movies, listening to a lot of his concerts and stuff. What really let me know he hadn't changed was when I got a chance to talk to him Wednesday. You know, he walked up and we got to talking, and you know, I was telling him about how the people here felt about it, you know, and how beautiful things he had done, and he really liked that man. I mean, he, you know, it was almost like he was almost in tears, you know, because he said, "Really, man?" I said, "Yeah, man." I said, "Hey, you know, it's like you left here and you took Peoria with you. You know, you didn't, you know, a lot of cats leave and hey, and that's it, you know, but he took it with him, you know, and when you say Peoria, that's Richard Pryor's town, you know." And we talked for about 15 minutes, talked about a lot of old cats, and he was telling me about that. He had talked to Johnny, and Johnny was doing a part, so, you know, and the thing that happened with me was, like, I talked to him, and I seen Rashad Sad, which is personal bodyguard, and I told him, I said, "Man, look here, I said, I need a job, man." You know, I said, "They don't have to be acting, I can do anything." So he said, "Well, let me get back with you." He took my phone, name and phone number, and I seen him today, and Cat, I said, "Man, did you do that?" He said, "Wait just a minute." He went, got the director and brought him over there and took my name and stuff, and I'm supposed to have a part Wednesday, which I won't know what it is if we get testing Wednesday, but it's just like that. He's like that with everybody, man, you know. Everybody gets a piece.
Mm-hmm. Johnny, you've had a chance to talk with Richard, and I understand you've even had a chance to shoot some scenes. What are some of the things that you think back about Richard that come to mind as we sit here now?
Well, you know, we used to have a lot of talent shows and things, you know. Richard would be on every talent show that came along, boy. And I would be on there, Ferguson, Bird Dog, which is Robert Hightower. Which is Robert Hightower read most all the time, because he could fade. Mm-hmm. But Richard would be on there, he'd be telling them jokes. But wasn't nobody laughing at him, they were laughing at Richard. See? But they didn't know in the years to come, those same jokes was going to make Richard $1 million. See? And, but Richard, you know, Richard really wasn't exposed like the rest of us in the streets. Because mm-hmm. he's pretty well kept close to home, right? And what he be saying about Buck telling them be at home at the same time, he means all of that, man. You know, but he sneak out sometimes and get with the fellas and things, get on them shows and things.
Uh-huh.
But he always been, he never was a real rowdy guy. Now, you know, he was pretty quiet and things. But he, and when he was young, he was still trying to get ahead. Like, he was thinking about the future. See?
If somebody would ask you a couple of months ago, do you think you'd ever be acting in the movies? Did you think this was going to happen to you?
No. Because, you know, after they said, well, they're going to have auditions at Juniors, I had second thoughts about it. Then I said, what have I got to lose, man? You know, I know, so I'm going to take this chance. Which I tried to take a lot of guys that's not doing anything. I was going to carry them up there in my car, you know, and let them get interviewed, you know. Everybody got a chance, the way that he was saying it, you know. So I just went up there, and I was in the line. They took me out of the line and took a picture, you know, and things like that. Say, well, we'll let you know about what's happening. But I would never thought that I would be in no movie, though. But I guess I'm in there. They shot it already, part of it.
What's the first thing you said to Richard when you saw him?
I was just standing in line behind the trailer. I wasn't expecting to see Richard then, because I wasn't thinking he was back in that area, actually, in the Eaton area right there. He came out of the trailer. And I was just standing in the line. You know, another guy was saying, I heard, you know Richard. I said, yeah, I've been around Richard most of his life, you know. So Richard just happened to come out of the trailer and come out. And he looked at me and he said, Disney? I said, yeah, man. He said, John? He said, yeah. So he just grabbed me and hugged me, you know, and started shaking my hand and things. People gawking, you know, yeah, the guy really do know him, you know, yeah. And things like, and they was telling me, man, why don't you call me down there and talk to him, you understand? But see, I know a man got a lot of problems on his mind, you know, he's directing, acting, and the producer of this thing, you know, I didn't want to tie him up with all those people, you know, trying to hold him the thing. But he just didn't seem like he wanted to leave, you know, he just kept standing there talking, holding my hand, shaking it, you know. And Richard's one of the most down-earth guys I think I've met in my life.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'd say that.
You know, we were talking outside, you're talking about Richard being down to earth and personal. You were telling me about a skit or a few things he used to do at Carver Center. You recall any of those?
Well, he did that skit, I don't really know the name of the skit that he did. It was supposedly when the white folks woke up that one morning, all black folks were gone, you know.
Yeah, I think I know the one you're talking about, the Day of Absence.
Right, he did that, and he did that skit, well, you know, years ago, W.I.O. had a, well, like they got that W.I.O. car now, they got a little red and a big red. So Richard did him up a skit with a little black, big black. just, you know, the kid was just, you know, just, he was humorous, man. Like, he was over the park one day, and the cat got to scuffing with some dudes over there. They got to fight and go on, man. And this is for real. When it was over with, Richard had on a white shirt. Well, little Richard had nothing but the cuff and his collar around his shirt. You know, it's just comical, man. You know, just whatever he did, it was just humorous, you know. Mm-hmm. But he did these, you know, he was, you hear him talk about a lot of them fights and a lot of them cats. He always wanted to be a regular, didn't he, man? He always wanted to be right with everybody.
He wanted to belong.
Yeah, belong. Yeah. That was, I think that was what really made him successful, because a lot, I think, he started from just really wanting to belong.
Johnny, one thing you said to me earlier is that this time, I think Richard feels like he belongs. He's back home.
Yeah.
What made you get that feeling as you was talking to him?
Well, you know, I guess most of the time, I haven't been here all the time that he's been coming back, but it seemed like he didn't feel like he was at home at all, you know. You know, maybe halfway, maybe not even halfway home, maybe a fourth of the way home. But I just heard him make this statement, you know. I heard him make the statement to his uncle that this is the first time he really felt that he was all the way back home, and you feel at home here, that everybody cared about him and things, you know. Right. And you can see the sincerity in his face, though. Right. See, you look at most people and tell. Like my father taught me a long time ago how to look at people in the eye and find out if they're lying or not to you, you know. And I could look at Richard and tell him, I believe he's very sincere about the whole thing, man.
Yeah, same thing I've seen in him.
What are some of the people that are not involved saying, I mean, you know, when you think about a man of Richard's stature right now in the industry to come back to Peoria, Illinois, bringing a lot of resources in here, putting a lot of people to work at a time when Peoria really needs it. Do the people really understand the impact of Richard being back here and what he's doing?
I don't think everybody does, man. I think some of them. The majority does.
I don't think it's really hit a lot of them yet.
Mm-hmm.
Of just what he's doing, you know. And well, I guess a lot of people would think he was doing it for a different reason, but me knowing Richard, I know Richard's doing it because this is Richard, man. And you know, well, like Johnny said a few minutes ago, you know, he feels at home. And you know, by him coming back and really feel at home this time, man, this is the most beautiful thing I think could have happened to him, man, because he's always wanted to belong, you know, with whether it was with a gang or with the pool hall or with the fellas, he just always wanted to belong. And I think this time that, like Johnny said, that he really feels it, and this is why. And some other reason, John, if you notice, like, you know, even with the protection and stuff that he has, security have, you know, he might come out of the trail and the security will try to group around him, and he'll just break through them, man, and just grab people, embracing them and hugging the little kids, man. And like, I have a little nephew that's doing one of the parts,
mm-hmm.
and with JoJo's friend, and like, they picked him up every morning and took him on the set and took care of him. I guess Richard got him up. He likes him. He got him a little pup. They got the shots and stuff. Delivered the puppy to the house and stuff. And I guess they're planning on taking him back to California with him, you know.
That's beautiful.
Yeah.
You know, what would you say to Richard? Because certainly we're going to send a copy of the show this evening. And, you know, I'm aware, as Johnny mentioned, when you're producing, and you're directing, and you're acting, you have a whole lot that you're going to deal with at one time. So a lot of the people that we're going to have on tonight are some people who didn't get a chance to talk to in the way they wanted to. And certainly you all have had a few brief minutes, but as he's got time to sit back and reflect on this tape this evening, what would you like to say to Richard this evening?
Well, myself, I was telling, no matter what, how he think other people think, you know, success is here alone, you know, but the people make you, you know. But, you know, if you think he's failing or something, just don't give up. Just keep on pushing. That's all I can tell you. You done got this for, I'm sure he can go all the way.
Right.
With the directing and the acting and so forth, et cetera, et cetera. You know, I think he can make it because he got, you know, he got to push. You know, he got everything it takes to be a success. So just keep on driving, don't give it up.
Mm-hmm. All I can say is what I told him when we wrapped this, man, I love you and you're beautiful and just keep on getting down.
Sure. I think that the both of you kind of put it together in terms of the sentiments that the students in our class and some of the young people who are operating the cameras tonight, because they kind of look up to Richard as a symbol. Well, if he made it, maybe then I can make it. And I think the other thing that we talked about, when you talk about producing and directing, and that's on the other side of the camera, most of the time some of us in our lives see some of our own people make it to the front side of the camera. But when you go back in the booth and you look around the stage and you look at the engineers and the technicians and the camera operators and the directors, you see very few of us. And I think that is a side of it that we can begin to break into. And I think some people are learning that from their experience here with Richard. So we certainly appreciate that. John, you had something that you wanted to say?
Yeah, of course. If some people's looking for Richard to fail, you see, they sitting in the background. They don't want him to make it now. There's a lot of people out there, maybe not here, but in Hollywood, you understand where I'm coming from? They don't want to see Richard make it as a director, you know, and an actor, and a producer, you know.
That's too much independence.
Yeah, see, they probably don't want Richard to have all that, but I still say he's going to make it regardless of what they want, because he got that drive, man. He got the drive. He's going to make it.
Well, let me say to you all again, I wish you all the best of luck in terms of your first adventure into the movie business. And let's face it, this may not be the last time. It just may be the first of many things to come.
Right.
So Richard may have done the ultimate in terms of coming home and taking some people back with him. And we certainly hope that's the case. Again, I want to thank you all for stopping in on CAPtions.
And I'm just so thrilled to be here. Over here in America, I'm so glad y'all took me out of die, homie. I used to live to be 150. Now I die of high blood pressure by the time I'm 52. And that thrills me to death. I'm just so pleased America's gonna last. They brought me over here in a boat. There's 400 of us come over here. 360 of us died on the way over here. I love that. That just thrilled me so. I don't know, you white folks are just so good to us. Got over here, another 20 of us died from disease. But you didn't have no doctors to take care of us. I'm so sorry you didn't. Upset you all some too, didn't it? Then they split us all up. Yes, sir, we took my mom over that way, took my wife that way, took my kids over yonder. I'm just so happy. I don't know what to do. I don't know what to do if I don't get 200 more years of this. Lord of mercy. Yes, sir, we. I don't know where my old mama is now. You up yonder in that big white folks in the sky. Y'all probably never forgot about it. But I ain't gonna never forget it.
You know, we're fortunate. We just had another old friend of Richard stop into the studio this evening. Miss Boardy May Booker. Good evening, Boardy. How are you?
Fine. How are you, Mr. Banks?
I'm doing just well. You know, you've had an opportunity to visit with Richard, but before you had that opportunity, Richard was being interviewed by some of the news media, and they asked him, who is it that you'd like to see that you haven't had a chance to see yet? And one of the people he said was Boardy May Booker. So I hope you all got a chance to spend a little time together today.
Yes, we did.
You're kind of excited about the possibility of being in the movie, Boardy?
Yes, I am, very.
Let's talk a little bit about the Richard you knew before he became a producer, director, movie star, comedian, the young fellow that put Peoria on the map.
Well, we growed up together. That was my childhood sweetheart. And he was crazy, you know. He always come by on a Sunday and take me to the show or bring me a little flower or anything and laugh and joke. And he's just a comical person. You know, he always had something to make somebody laugh about, always.
Has Richard's success in the movies changed him a lot?
No, it hasn't. Not to me, it hasn't. He's still the Richard that I know.
And that's kind of a rare quality in people, you have to admit.
Yes, it is.
What's your feeling about Richard coming home? What are the people feeling about him? What are you hearing?
That he have never forgot about Peoria, Illinois. He gonna always think about his friends, his hometown, and the people that he grew up with, especially me.
The part that you all talked about, what? Tell me what you're gonna be doing.
Well, he explained to me today in the trailer, it's a little part in the back seat in the junkyard where we was together, unfortunately. And it's just gonna be just a small part. Mm-hmm. But I'm thrilled to be doing it with him, you know. I was so nervous today and I started crying. He had little tears in his eyes, you know. He never will forget me, he said.
That's beautiful. You know, many people have been touched because of his presence here. Did you ever think you would be sitting here today talking about a part in a movie?
No, definitely not. It never did cross my mind, even be close to Richard in a movie. I have always wanted to be with Richard on talk shows, but Richard said he would be talking kind of bad language, you know, little things that we used to do together. And I turned one part down of being with him on, Johnny Carson. I had the opportunity one time to be on a talk show with him, but I turned it down.
But you're going to accept this one?
Yes. I think this might be my last chance because I'm getting up in age now, and I like to relive that little incident.
Uh-huh. Buddy, you know, one of the things that I'm impressed with is the number of black folk who are in one way or another participating with what Richard is trying to do. Is that something that Richard is making a special effort to make sure happens, or is it just happening that way?
I think he's making an effort for it to happen that way, because as what I seen today down there while he was filming, it was a lot of blacks and some of his friends, you know, just like Mr. Dismute. You know, I enjoyed hearing him about playing a part, and Mr. Bobby Cagle. I really enjoyed it very much. It did something to me, you know.
That Richard's kind of taking care of his friends.
Right, and he takes care of them too.
Okay, if you could, if Richard was gonna be viewing this tape, what are some of the things that you would want to share to bring him up to date with what's happening in Peoria that you may not have had a chance to share? What are some of the changes that you think makes Peoria maybe a different Peoria than the Peoria he knew?
Well, it's a lot of things Mr. Banks could make changes. You know, for instance, when we was growing up, Peoria was wide open. You know, it's closed down now. It's kind of tight around here. And I wish it could be like it was when he was here. When he come back here again, I hope it could be just lively up for him, you know. And, you know, so he could see, you know, that Peoria isn't just gone completely out of the picture, you know. And I wish some way we could get together and just try to make it possible for him, you know. Some of the people downtown at the city councilman, whatever, you know, to make it, you know, a little bit better place for him to come back to at all times.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. I don't think we've really did the kind of welcome that we could do as a family to welcome Richard back.
Right, it could have been a little more than what he got, you know, but he's satisfied, he's happy, you know.
Okay, what would you say to some of the young folk who see Richard as an idol, who aspire to be a star? If he had an opportunity to share a thought with him, what are some of the things you think he'd say to some of the young folks?
Well, you know, you have to work hard, just like Richard did. And, you know, he would tell them, say, well, if whatever you want to be, if they want to be in the movies, you know, you have to work hard at it. You got to let a lot of things go aside And just have to put your mind to it, just like Richard did, you know. He kept on going, he kept on going. He's at his peak now, you know. And he's going to make it. I hope he can go a little bit higher, but I know he can't. So he's higher what he's going to get now. But the young people today, you should have seen them, Mr. Banks. They were so happy just to touch him, you know. And one little boy told him, said, I'd like to be in the movies with you. He said, okay, I'll give it a try. See?
Mm-hmm. That's beautiful. Well, look, we certainly wish you the best in terms of your involvement with the movie this time. And very few people are able to be in the position that you're in to be able to reflect back.
Yes, that's all I've been hearing since I've been coming home. Boydie Mae Booker, Richard Pryor, you know, it's just a tradition. He never called me Boydie Mae. He always called me Boydie Mae Booker, you know. And it makes me feel so good.
Well, we're going to have some more guests who are coming into the studio, but like I said, we're glad you were able to stop by. I really appreciate you taking time to do that. And for those of you in our viewing audience, we're going to have more friends of Richard's shortly.
Hi, Richard. My name is Valencia McLean. I would like to thank you for coming to Peoria and bringing something back to our community. I wish you continued success in your future. We love you.
Naturally, you're welcome to Peoria. My name is Stuart James Beck III. I would very much like to be in your picture. I feel I can be a great asset to your picture. You can contact me at 686-1476 or 674-4888. Thank you very much.
Things that we know that is sincere for Peorians who love Richard and who feel thrilled that he felt enough to come back to Peoria and share all this glory with us. You know, very, very seldom that things occur in Peoria. And because of him, we all in the national news, and we feel very, very proud and very sincerely love Richard, and we just feel great. And we want to give some plaques and some awards to Richard today, and I'll turn you over to our mayor, Mayor Maloof.
Before we give these, I think, more than deserving plaques to Richard Pryor, I think it's well for us to say here in Peoria that it's just great, absolutely great, that a person of his stature would come back, a man who has never really forgotten his city and his roots. And I think it's just great for him to come from where he has been, to come back to a point in time in his life, and especially at a time like this, Richard, when our community is in such economic distress, for you to do this makes it more, all the more important. And I just, as a mayor, as a new mayor of the community, and having known the Pryor family and the Maloof families from down on 6th Street and 1st Street for years, it's kind of good to look back and to see where we're at today. So on behalf of all of that too, I'd like to say something about a man like Richard Pryor before I make this proclamation, and that Dr. Bob Shuler talked about a person who it takes guts to get out of a rut. You've got to have aches before there are breaks. You've got to have pains before there are gains, and then you have to dare to dream. Richard has been not only a dreamer all of his life, but he's making those dreams come true. And you're making them true for us, and you are a great example to all of these young people around here, to all of your group and your staff. We love you and we thank you. On behalf of all of that, now that I'm only the mayor for 4 days, I'm going to make you the honorary mayor today. That can't be too smart, can it? Here I am, giving the way before I even got it, for heaven's sake. But we are making you the honorary mayor for today, Richard Pryor. You want to do that? He's really deserving of more than that, Richard. This is like Strike It Rich today. Also, we have another plaque and a proclamation from the mayor's office that reads, "Whereas Peoria, Illinois is proud to claim Richard Pryor, famous comedian, actor, and author of stage, screen, and television, as one of its favorite and outstanding sons. And whereas Richard Pryor was born in Peoria, Illinois, attended local schools, where he began his stage debut as Rumpelstiltskin at the age of 12, embarking his career that has brought him wide acclaim." Why are you laughing? I'm getting serious and you're laughing. Rumpelstiltskin bring back a few memories? Okay. Whereas Richard Pryor has been recognized for over 30 motion pictures during his career and was inducted into the Black Filmmakers Hall of Fame in 1984. And whereas Richard Pryor will be in Peoria, Illinois during the next few weeks visiting relatives, renewing acquaintances, and will be filming his latest picture, JoJo Dancer, Your Life is Calling. And whereas Richard Pryor has not only brought recognition to Peoria, his hometown, by his return to film his latest movie, but has instilled a sense of pride and spirit within all Peorians and is a stabilizing influence for hundreds of people from all walks of life and all stages. Now, therefore, I, James A. Maloof, Mayor of the City of Peoria, do hereby proclaim May 10th as Richard Pryor Day in Peoria, Illinois, and we love you. Thank you. I told you this is Strike It Rich Day. If that wasn't enough, you got any more hands? We're also going to give you a key to the city. I really think it's the key to our hearts because you represent much to us. Your humility, your example for people is so genuine. That's important. And if you ever do anything else for us, you've already done enough. There's another little paperweight or something. So it's Strike It Rich time for Richard Pryor and Peoria. And we have other, James, you have somebody else you want to introduce?
John Gwynn, who is the state president of the NAACP, who's been around here a long time. And plus Roland Barris, who's state controller, was going to be here with his schedule because he also wanted to be here to at this time when we are doing things with Richard.
We have another presentation from Congressman Bob Michael's office. Mr. Ray LaHood would like to do this.
Richard, Josh, on behalf of Congressman Michael, I'm sorry he can't be here today, but I can tell you that very grateful for what you're doing for our community and the fact that you've come back here and are shooting this film here. On behalf of the congressman, we have a flag that was flown over the United States Capitol in your name, and we'll be presenting the certificate to you and also a pen in commemoration of his thanks for what you're doing. Thank you very much.
Great amount. Our Sheriff George Shadid got the jump on me by making him an honorary deputy of the day because he didn't like Richard's New York Yankee hat here in Cubs and Cardinal land. George, you want to...
It's pretty hard to match what you just did, Mr. Mayor, and the Congressman. So Richard, congratulations on being back in Peoria. And you are a special deputy on the Sheriff's Department. We're that deputy.
My lifelong friend, and I'm the mayor, and he didn't even make me a deputy.
What's that? You don't deserve it.
I'd like to say that I'm very grateful to my friends here in Peoria, people that I don't even know have been so kind to the production company and have helped us and gone out of their way. I'd like to say that I love my Uncle Dickie for being here. And my Aunt Dee is here, and I'd just like to thank my family, my friends, and say that it's really, I'm glad that it's a Richard Pryor honor. I'm happy to be a deputy and happy to be honorary mayor for today. And as the deputy for today, I'd like to say nobody will be arrested today.
Wait now, that's only in the county, not in the city. In the city, that's my character.
Thank you very much. Thank you all very much.
Mayor Pryor, how about a nice round of applause for Richard Pryor?
Would you wait?
Well, now let's go to work.
Thank you, sir.
Hello, we're back. And for those of you who are just joining us, you're watching CAPtions. This is Mike Banks, and we've been talking with friends of Richard Pryor. As a matter of fact, on my immediate right, we also have a friend who just dropped in the studio, Mr. Bill Fortune, who is currently working with the production JoJo Dancer. Bill, exactly what is your capacity with the production now?
Oh, well, my capacity with it is Richard's bodyguard.
Bill, can you, you know, having the role of bodyguard means you had a chance to kind of travel and move with Richard through crowds to have a chance to really kind of survey the receptiveness that Richard is receiving while he's here. What has been Richard's impact on the city since he's been back?
Well, you know, the impact has been beautiful. You know, nothing but love from the people, you know. We haven't had near incident whatsoever. Everybody wants to shake his hand or take a picture. And it's been very beautiful and very moving.
I've noticed, I've had an opportunity to chat with three or four other individuals on our program this evening who are either going to be playing certain roles in the movie or in some way shared some friendships with Richard growing up. It appears that Richard is reaching out to involve Peorians, especially black Peorians, and his friends. What have you seen of that as a person with a much closer view of the situation?
Well, Richard is reaching out to everybody, all his bosom buddies, and even the elderly people, you know. Like John's Barbecue, he's going to give him a part. Jimmy Binkley, Jimmy Bell, Hank Nesbitt, you know. And you know, it's just, they're shocked, you know, when he says, well, do you want a part in the picture? You know, and they say, huh? You know, it's very, you know, this man, you know, you heard so much about him, but more or less, he preaches nothing but love now. You know, there's no violence, no drugs, and it's beautiful, you know. And for him, you understand, it's like Barty May. You know, he said, I want to see Barty May, you know, which is so beautiful. And then when he did see her, you know, kind of a tear was in his eye, and she got to crying, you know. Yeah, that type of love,
real.
You know, it's real.
You know, another aspect of Richard's coming home to Peoria has meant a lot of dollars and a lot of business activity at a time when we need it. What is the broader community's perception? Have you been able to gauge that yet?
Well, you know, by his companies being here, they're spending $50,000 to $80,000 a day. And I hear him talking about revenue, you understand, be something like over $2 million for this community. Peoria has accepted him, you know. Mr. Maloof, give him a plaque and a proclamation and a key to the city. And for Richard, you know, that was beautiful. And even Mr. Polk came by, and more or less, that was beautiful. And the comments that John Gwynn made was beautiful. As far as employment, he's employing so many blacks and whites, you know. People that used to live by, people that, you know, say, well, I used to know you so-and-so. Oh, yes, hi, Mrs. Jones, you know. I want you to meet my son. Well, you want a part in the picture? Yeah. Yeah, take care of it. And it's beautiful, you know. And you know, everybody's there. Everybody wants something. And this man, you understand, is just giving, you know. And I think of the people that he has put on. Two young ladies gave him a thank you card, which was very, very, it moved him very much, you know. That's showing appreciation. You know how that is, though, Mike.
Sure. When you think about the task that is before him in the context of this production, he has responsibility as a producer, a director, and also acting. What kind of pressure or what kind of weight does that put on an individual in his position?
Well, Mike, doing all three puts a whole lot of pressure on him because he wants it, you know, to be as perfect as it can be. And I know the people have stood out in the rain and all this stuff waiting, you know, and he's in there going through the script at night, in the mornings, you know, making changes. And it's very mind-boggling, you know. But he's handled it beautiful. You know, he's under a lot of pressure because this is the first time he has come back to Peoria to do something.
Mm-hmm.
You know, as I would say, to perform, you know, and he wants it right. He says it will be right, you know. But Rich is under a whole lot of pressure, you understand, by doing all three. And by being, you know, in the movie business, and, you know, he's got some of he's got the best people working with him.
Mm-hmm.
And he gets a lot of directions from them. But more or less, he has the final say.
Sure. Some of the younger people who aspire to be a Richard Pryor, a star, a success, what are some of the things you can say to them this evening, having observed the environment? What can they be doing to prepare themselves?
Well, first of all, Mike, you know, to be a Richard Pryor, you know, you got to have that inner self that you want to succeed. You know, like people say, you got to pay your dues, you know. Nobody come and tap you on the shoulder and say, well, you it. Like Rich, you went from here to New York, you know, from New York to California, and played in little clubs and whatever, you know. And I'd say to the young generation that's coming up now that wants to be a Richard Pryor, first of all, you got to have an education. You know, you got to stay in school. It's not, you know, it's just the idea. If you got the education, that piece of paper, and you don't make it, you have something else to fall back on.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, stay in school, stay off of drugs, and stay away from the liquor. And, you know, like I say, you got to be at the right place at the right time.
Mm-hmm.
You know, to aspire to be a Richard Pryor. You know, that's what it's going to take.
Sure. I know we've got some young folk who are operating cameras, even as we sit here tonight, who this is their first time actually experiencing what it's like to be involved in the technical side. A lot of people don't realize there is a lot of opportunity in that movie industry, and all of it, as we're finding out here in Peoria, is not in front of the camera. I understand that Richard has also been very concerned about all aspects of involvement, not just in front of the camera, but behind the scenes or wherever we can put some folk who can deliver a quality product. What do you see on the horizon? What will Richard leave? What will we have learned from this experience?
Well, I feel, you understand, Mike, what we will learn when he leaves is that a black man can make it, you know, and more or less there's a lot of ways a person can make it. He don't have to be a star. He can be behind the camera. And there's a lot of friends that I have met from his Indigo company and from the Columbia Pictures that have been in the business 20, 25 years. Some just starting. And more or less, you know, they was rapping to me, you understand, about how they made it. And more or less, well, I know so-and-so, and so-and-so knows so-and-so. And, you know, and Richard heard about it. So, you know, he reached out for them because they were good, you know. So, you know, the impact on Peoria, you understand, you know, people are going to be able, when they go to California, New York, Detroit, Chicago, St. Louis, you know, behind this picture, say, well, I'm from Peoria. Oh, that's where that picture was made.
Right.
You know, and that's going to be a big impact for Peoria.
You know, as I sit here listening to you, I can't help but feel in some way that what Richard is doing now will help many young folk. You know, I'm a what they call a transient. I moved here, even though I've been here quite a while now, but I'm from Chicago. But when you travel with guys and we go traveling, they don't say that they're from Peoria like they're proud. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And I think that what this will help do is help folk be proud to say, I'm from Peoria.
Right, right.
And if that happens, it just, to me, kind of turns on a water faucet of opportunity, because we must be proud of who we are and where we come from if we expect to go anywhere.
Right.
I certainly have enjoyed chatting with you, Bill. I know that you're busy. You're out on the set all day, and to drop in on the studio like this, I appreciate it. And certainly, if there was something that you could say in parting remarks, I'd appreciate if you'd share them with the viewers.
Well, you know, on parting remarks, Mike, the only thing I would have to say to the young folk, you know, get that piece of paper, stay in school, learn a trade, because more or less there's a whole lot of opportunities out there. And people, you know, like you're saying, now I'm proud that I am from Peoria. I've always been proud of Peoria, because more or less anywhere you go, you know, somebody says, well, that's where Richard Pryor lives, or was born, right? Yeah, you know. But now it's going to be twofold behind this picture. And, you know, the remarks I'm saying are not that good, but more or less, I'm saying it from the heart. You know, I'm not just putting on something.
Right.
And Mike, you know, I've been knowing you for a long time, and I love you too.
Bill, I really appreciate it. You know, I think there's one side of this that I'm going to be looking forward to. Richard has a new movie that's going to be coming out. We're going to talk about that more in the program. But love is a two-way thing. And I just want to make sure that when the movies hit, that Richard Pryor's acting in, that we see each other standing in a real long line.
I'll be there.
All right.
Thank you, man.
Take care.
Mr. Pryor, could you say hi to Mr. Banks one more time?
Hey, Community Action Agency.
Yes, hi, Mr. Banks.
And the viewers of CAPtions.
Viewers of CAPtions.
Thank you.
God bless.
Excuse me, sir.
Thank you very much.
on my mind all the time. Running out of through my mind. I'm not too blind to see, lady, all the happiness you bring, to me. Oh baby, you make me feel fancy free. Now honey, my life was all just a mess. What I should have done was just confess that I love you. I'm the friend I really do love you.
Welcome home. It has been our pleasure to bring this special program to you. Certainly it was dedicated to our friend, our brother, our son from Peoria, Mr. Richard Pryor, an outstanding comedian, actor, writer, director who has become a towering figure in the entertainment industry. His awards range from the National Academy of Television Arts and Sciences to the Black Filmmakers Hall of Fame as recent as 1984. On behalf of all of us in Peoria, and especially the Community Action family, thank you, Richard, for not forgetting Peoria. And now we'll give you a special parting message from one of the members of our Community Action family, Ms. Rosa Cole.
We're so glad to see you come home again. Thought all of our hopes were gone. 'cause you mean just that much to us. Now, speaking of beautiful, now Richard, now you know, this town loves you. Everybody in this town loves you. Even me. You know something, I wrote this red, especially for you, kid. So wherever you are looking, believe Peoria loves you. And we hope you all the success all the rest of your life. And I know we've all had good times, bad times, and through it all, Richard, you kicked all the way through it. So you're like old Timex watch. You take a licking and keep on ticking. But we want to let you know you're beautiful to us, and we love you, and we're going to follow you wherever you go. And just remember that our hearts are with you no matter what you do or where you go. And just remember that, because we love you. And welcome home, dude. All right.
To Mr. Pryor, we students of the JTPA video training class would like to thank you for coming to Peoria to film your new show. Your filming here will have a lasting effect on Peoria as a whole. We will never forget you. Thank you, the JTPA video training class.
P.S. Next time when you come to the city of Peoria, we hope that we can videotape you. Thank you.
Thank you, Rick.
Thank you,
man.